In this video, we discuss about measure of central tendency. That is any statistical measure which gives an idea about the position of the point around which other observation cluster is called measure of central tendency. That means for any data, the most representative number is known as central tendency. There are three commonly used averages called as measure of central tendency, that is mean, median and mode. Here we discuss about arithmetic mean. The arithmetic mean is simply called an average. Now let's see the formula. We have two types of data, only observation and frequency distribution. In frequency distribution, we have ungrouped data and group data. Now for only observation, mean is summation x upon n. Summation x means addition of all the observation, and the small n means total number of observation. In frequency distribution, for ungrouped data and group data, mean is equal to summation fx upon summation F. We can also find mean using deviation, or we can say that using assumed mean. For that, the formula is x bar is equal to a plus summation fd upon summation f. Here deviation is x minus a, and the second formula is x bar is equal to a plus h summation fd upon summation f, and here deviation is x minus a upon h. The second formula is applicable only when the size of each class is same, means whenever we can find common difference h, then and only then we can use the second formula. Let's see the example. The marks obtained by 10 students in class 12 in physics examination are these. Find the arithmetic mean. Now we can see that we have only observation, and for only observation, the formula is x bar is equal to summation x upon n. Summation x means addition of all the marks, small n means total number of students. So we have 358 divided by 10. So the mean is 35.80. Second example. Calculate the arithmetic mean of the following marks obtained by students in mathematics. Here we have frequency distribution, ungrouped data. And for frequency distribution, we have three formula. We solve this example by all three formula. But first of all, we solve this example by x bar is equal to summation fx upon summation f. Now for summation f, we add all the frequency. In sabka addition karna hai. So we have summation f is equal to 384. Now after that, for summation fx, we add one more column, fx. Now for fx, we multiply all the frequency with corresponding variable, means x. So for this value, we multiply x, that is 5, and f is 20. So 5 into 20. 100. Then for this value, 10 into 43, that is 430. Similarly, we can find remaining value. After that, add all this value. So summation fx is equal to 8530. Now substitute these two value in the formula. 8530 divide by 384. So x bar is equal to 22.21. That is our arithmetic mean. But the same example assume mean ka use karke bhi solve kar sakte hai. For that, let's see the calculation. For assuming the first formula is x bar is equal to a plus summation fd upon summation f, and here deviation is x minus a, and the second formula is a plus h summation fd upon summation f, here deviation is x minus a upon h. Now deviation d, that is x minus a. So d ko define karne ke liye first of all jo variable hai means x, x mein se koi bhi ek value capital A assume karni hai. Okay, in mein se koi bhi ek capital A assume kar lo. Let's take capital A is equal to 30. Okay, so for first value yahan pe x hai 5 and the a is 30, so 5 minus 30 minus 25. Then for this value x is 10 and a is 30, so 10 minus 30, that is minus 20. Then 15 minus 30, similarly we can find all the remaining value. Now fd means we multiply all the frequency with corresponding deviation. For this value we multiply 20 and minus 25. 20 into minus 25, minus 500. Then for this value 43 into minus 20, that is minus 860. Similarly, find the remaining all value. Now add all this value. So we have summation FD is equal to minus 2990. Now we substitute this value in the formula. X bar is equal to A plus summation FD upon summation F. Here a is 30, summation fd is minus 2990, and the summation f is 384, and simplify this, so the answer is 22.21. and in this formula the deviation is x minus a upon h. Here we take a is equal to 30 and h means common difference between variable. तो जो x की value है सब में अगर आप देखोगे तो common difference सब value में difference कितना है 5, so h is equal to 5. Now x minus a upon h, that is our deviation. For this value x is 5, a is 30 and h is 5, so 5 minus 30, that is minus 25, and minus 25 by 5, so that is minus 5. Then for this value here x is 10, so 10 minus 30 is minus 20, and minus 20 by 5, that is minus 4. You can directly write यहाँ पे फर्स्ट माइनस 5 है, देन माइनस 4, माइनस 3, माइनस 2, माइनस 1, 0, 1, 2, 3 एंड 4. नाउ नेक्स्ट फॉर FD मल्टीप्लाई फ्रीक्वेंसी विथ डेविएशन. इन दोनों का मल्टीप्लाई कर लो, सो दैट इज माइनस 100. then 43 into minus 4, 75 into minus 3, 67 into minus 2, 72 into minus 1, 45 into 0, 39 into 1, 9 into 2, 8 into 3, and 6 into 4. So summation FD is minus 598. Now substitute this value in the formula and simplified. So X bar is 22.21. But remember, this formula applicable only when we able to find H. That means जो variable है वहाँ पे common difference define कर सकते हैं, तभी second formula use कर सकते हैं. One more example. Find the arithmetic mean of the marks from the following data. Now यहाँ पे हम marks observe करेंगे, that is in class form, group में दिए हैं. 0 to 10 में number of students 12, then 10 to 20 में number of students है 18. We can solve this example by all three formula. So first let's take x bar is summation fx upon summation f. पहले तो जो frequency उनका addition कर लेते हैं. So summation f is 100. Now x, जो previous example था वहाँ पे जो marks थे वो ungrouped थे. So that is our variable. But यहाँ पे क्या है? जो marks है वो class के form में है. So first x define करना पड़ेगा. जो class है उसकी mid value. That is our x. And after that we defined fx. पहले x mid value of the class. So for this 0 to 10 उसकी mid value क्या होगी? That is 0 plus 10 by 2, 5. Then for this यहाँ पे class है 10 to 20, तो 10 plus 20 by 2. Then 20 to 30 की mid value होगी 25. 30 to 40 की mid value 35, and the mid value of 40 to 50 is 45, and the last one is 55. Now fx, to frequency and variable corresponding value ka multiply karenge. 12 into 5, 18 into 15, 27 into 25, 20 into 35, 15 into 45, and 8 into 55. Then we add all this value. So summation fx is 2820. Now substitute this value in the formula. 2820 divided by 100, that is 28.20. So the mean is 28.20. We can solve this example using assumed mean or step deviation. So in that, the formula is x bar is equal to a plus summation fd upon summation f, and here deviation is equal to x minus a. Let's create the table. Now deviation, that is x minus a, तो जो variable है उसमें से कोई भी एक पहले capital A assume करते हैं. Let's take a is equal to 25. Now 5 minus 25, that is minus 20. Then 15 minus 25, 25 minus 25 is 0. 35 minus 25, 45 minus 25, and the last one is 55 minus 25. Now FD. तो फ्रीक्वेंसी एंड डेविएशन का मल्टीप्लाई करना है. तो यहाँ पे फ्रीक्वेंसी 12 है and the deviation is minus 20. So 12 into minus 20, that is minus 240. Next, frequency is 18 and the deviation is minus 10. So 18 into minus 10, that is minus 180. 27 into 0, then 20 into 10. 15 into 20. 8 into 30. Now add all this value. So summation FD 320. And after that, we substitute this value in the formula and simplified. So the answer is 28.20. And the last formula, x bar is equal to a plus h summation fd upon summation f, where d is x minus a upon h. Here summation f is 100, then x means mid value of the class, that is 5, 15, 25, 35, 45 and 55. Now for deviation, let's take a is equal to 25 and here h, common difference between the variable 5, 15, 25 in subme, difference at 10, so h is equal to 10. Now x minus a upon h, so 5 minus 25, that is minus 20, and minus 20 by my 10, so that is minus 2. Now we can directly write jo assume kiya hai capital hai uske samne hoga c 0 1 2, 3. Now FD, तो frequency and deviation, दोनों का multiply करोगे तो 12 into minus 2, that is minus 24, 18 into minus 1, 27 into 0, 20 into 1, 15 into 2, and 8 into 3. Now add all this value. Summation FD is 32, and after that substitute value in the formula, simplified, we get 28.20. agar tino calculation tino formula ko observe karoge to jo calculation hai wo easy going last formula mein hoti hai, kyunki yahan pe jo bhi number hai wo small number mein convert ho jata hai. So we can calculate without using calculator. Okay. Now in this example, the frequency distribution is in more than form. That means jo number of students hai, that is our cumulative frequency. F नहीं है वो cumulative frequency है. तो पहले F define करना पड़ेगा and जो marks है that is in more than form, तो उसके लिए पहले उसको class में convert करना पड़ेगा. तो we need to find class and frequency. Now before that, let's see the geometrical representation. Now marks more than 0 and the number of students is 60, means isko hum number line pe display karenge, to more than 0 marks kitne student hai, so that is 60. Now let's draw one more line, and in that more than 10 marks, that is number of student is 56, and more than 20, we have number of student is 40. Okay, yahan pe hum dekhenge to ye more than 0, this is more than 10 and this is more than 20. So 0 to 10, 10 to 20. तो जो क्लास है वो हम डिफाइन करेंगे 10 के इंटरवल में, और आप डायरेक्टली भी यहाँ पे ऑब्जर्व कर सकते हो, तो जो वैल्यू है उन सबके बीच में डिफरेंस 10 का है. तो अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट अवर फर्स्ट क्लास इज 0 टू 10, देन सेकंड क्लास 10 टू 20, सिमिलरली 20 टू 30, 30 टू 40, 40 टू 50 एंड 50 टू 60. नाउ फ्रीक्वेंसी, तो मोर देन 0 एंड मोर देन 10. तो जो मोर देन 10 में नंबर ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स है 56, वो यहाँ पे इंक्लूड हो रहे हैं. मीन्स जो 60 है उसमें 56 इंक्लूड हो रहा है. तो हमको क्या करना पड़ेगा, 0 टू 10 के लिए 60 माइनस 56 दोनों को माइनस करना है. तो फॉर 0 टू 10 The number of student is 4. 60 minus 56, that is 4. Similarly, 10 more than 10 number of student is 56 and more than 20 number of student is 40. ये जो 40 है वो यहाँ पे भी include हो रहा है. तो 56 minus 40, that is number of students between 10 to 20 and that is 16. We can calculate this value directly. See, 20 to 30. तो क्या करना है? More than 20 and more than 30. उसमें जो number of students है, that is 40 and 20. तो 40 minus 20. 20. Okay. Similarly, for 30 to 40 के लिए जो 30 to 40 में number of students है, उन दोनों को minus कर दो. 20 minus 10. ओके एंड 40 टू 50 होगा 7, 50 टू 60. नाउ यहाँ पे यू कैन राइट मोर देन 50 और 50 टू 60. द मोर देन 53 है, सो यहाँ पे हम बाय डिफॉल्ट लिखेंगे 3. नाउ ऐड ऑल द वैल्यू. सो समेशन एफ इज 60 फॉर एफ एक्स. एक्स डिफाइन करना पड़ेगा, दैट इज मिड वैल्यू ऑफ द क्लास. देन एफ एक्स 0 टू 10, उसकी मिड वैल्यू होगी 5. नाउ इफ यू सी, तो यहाँ पे डिफरेंस 10 का है, तो डोंट नीड टू कैलकुलेट ऑल मिड वैल्यू ऑफ द क्लास. वी कैन एड 10 इन 5, सो वी हैव 15. देन उसमें 10 ऐड करोगे तो 25, 35. Okay, this is our x. Now multiply x with f, so we have fx. And the last, add all this value 1590. Now substitute the value in the formula and simplified. So the answer is 26.50. Okay, thank you.